I just want to take a moment here to just share a little what God has been doing for me, or what he did for me. And the scripture that comes to mind is, "And my God shall supply all your need according to his glory and riches by Christ Jesus." Missions has been burning on my heart for a while. With COVID and everything, I was like, okay, maybe that dream might not be coming anytime soon. So I happened to be watching a sermon online. It was Pastor Paul preaching, and during his message he had brought up the Mexico missions trip, and I instantly felt a real pull in my heart, and I was like, oh, okay, Lord, like, do you want me on that trip? And I just began praying about it and seeking the Lord on it, and just kind of leaving it with God, and if this is the right timing, and how am I going to do this financially. And I just heard him, the Holy Spirit, tell me that just call the church, put your name in, and I'll take care of the rest. And I thought that was a pretty cool word, but I like confirmation, and I'm a little bit like Thomas in the Bible there, that just needs confirmation, that needs hard proof. So I made an appointment with Pastor Paul to go for coffee one night and just have a chat, and I wanted to talk to him about it. Something told me I needed to talk to him first. So I did so, booked him in for a Thursday night meeting, and during the week I was visiting my auntie, and she had shared with me that she had had a dream that she wanted to help me financially for this missions trip. And I was like, wow, okay, God, well, there's a bit of a confirmation, okay. So then the excitement was really beginning to stir in my heart. So I was anticipating my coffee with Pastor Paul. We met up and we were talking about several things, and then we started talking about missions trips in particular. And as we were talking and sharing about what they do over there and how things go and what to anticipate while being on the missions trip and being in Mexico, the fire inside was just really lighting up and really stirring, and I was getting emotional a little bit when speaking about certain aspects of what we'd be doing down there. And nearing the end of our time together, Pastor had said, don't let finances determine whether or not you go or want to step out and sign up. So I took that advice and prayed again at night, and woke up the next morning and was thinking about it in the morning at work. And at 10 o'clock, I decided to phone the church and spoke with Jody, and then she handed me off to Karen, and then I said, hey, I would like to sign up for the missions trip. I really feel I should be there, and I really feel that I meant to go this year. So she was delighted and put me on the list, and then informed me that the deposit was due the following week, June 25th. And I was like, whoa, okay, and how much was that and everything? And I kind of had the little panic button, because I was like, oh boy, that's a week. So I says, okay, just leave that with me, we'll figure it out. So I got off the phone and says, okay, God, if you want me there, provide the funds. And as my work day is going on, it was about an hour and a half later, I grabbed my phone to change a song or something. I just picked up my phone for some reason, and I felt the Holy Spirit tell me to check my email. So I open up my email and I'm just scrolling through, not realizing what I'm looking at, and then all of a sudden I see a post from Canada Revenue Agency. First thought, I was like, oh, okay, this can't be good, I'm being audited or something like that. So I just click on it, and it turns out I was reassessed for some taxes for the past 3 years, and all the money I needed for this trip, to pay for the trip and to cover my time off work, was almost to the dollar what I needed. So I was like, okay, God, I guess I'm going on a missions trip. And so I just wanted to share this with you guys. Just, you know, when you hear that voice, when you hear God tell you something, act on it. And yes, okay, if you need some confirmation, get confirmation, but he is faithful and he will provide all your needs. If it's Spirit-led, he will provide, and we have to worry about nothing. So yes, be encouraged, bless you, and take care.